Ben from Tanami here, folks, today with the Cedar Summit Tanami TM2 Comforter.
Hit it.
This is a lightweight downfield comforter or quilt that brings hiking technology into the camping world so you can make for a lightweight camping setup. So this comforter is just a big square quilt, if you like, or a doona. It's filled with down. It's a perfect lightweight replacement to, say, a bulky sleeping bag or, say, a synthetic doona that you might use in a swag or a rooftop tent. Adding one of these to the swag or rooftop tent is going to make rolling it up so much easier because this will pack down smaller. And it's also going to make closing your rooftop tent easier because you're not getting the resistance of all the fabric in a bulky sleeping bag. Really versatile product, got multiple uses. We're going to run through all of that with you today. But when you buy your Tanami 2, you get the product here, and that comes loosely packed in this storage bag here, which is a great product to use to store it in, loosely packed when you're not using it. This measures about 48 by 33 by 20, just a zipper top on that one. You get a little guide on dimensions, temperature ratings, et cetera, and you also get the down certificate, which is the actual certificate that came to show the tests of the down that's inside the bag. So it's a 750 loft down in here. Certificate inside most likely says a much higher loft than the 750 rated here, just to show that it is a good quality down inside. Now, it doesn't come with a compression sack. Because it's not designed for hiking, it's more car camping. It goes inside a swag or loosely packed inside a car, but you can fit it inside a small Cedar Summit compression sack if you like, 10 liter compression sack there. So if you did want to pack it down smaller, grab one of those, it's an extra accessory. Now, construction of the bag is all synthetic material. So the outside here is a 30 denier DWR treated nylon. It's going to resist a little bit of water and also stains and that sort of thing. On the inside, a 20 denier soft touch nylon. This is a really nice feeling fabric. It doesn't have a really cold feel about it, and it has got a nice soft feel to go against your skin. And sandwiched in between that is 750 plus premium ultra dry down. This is a really good quality down with an ultra dry treatment that if it does get a bit of moisture on it, it's still going to maintain some loft down. Previously, if it got wet, just lost all its insulation properties, but this has a treatment to minimize that. And the construction of the bag is with these horizontal baffles. So if we spread it out a bit like this, we can see we've got these baffles that run across the bag this way with these stitching lines here. And it's what's called a box wall construction, which means this inner layer here and this outer layer here don't actually meet. Where this stitching point is here and this stitching point is here, there's a little layer of fabric there so that each of these channels is its own tube. And it never actually meets top to bottom. So you've got tubes like this full of down. And what that allows the down to do is loft up to an even height right across your entire body. So you get an entire layer of warmth. Bags that aren't as warm as this will have little pinch points in it. So each of these are sewn top to bottom like this, which means you do get a cold spot in there. So it's not so much for a really cold weather camping. Now, they give this bag a 2-degree rating. You can't test these bags to the same EN standard that a sleeping bag that actually zips closed on each side will test to. Because it doesn't close up, it can't be tested to the same standard. But that 2-degree rating is based on Cedar Summit's experience and history in the sleeping bag industry. They know that roughly this amount of downfill in this sort of construction is going to provide warmth at about this temperature, assuming you're sleeping on a warm mat. We'll show you a bit more on mats shortly. Now, running through the features of the bag, I'll spread it out. I've got it laid on top of a few different products under here that I want to show you that it's compatible with. Now, 210 centimeters in length and 205 centimeters in height this way. We start with the features on the bottom of the bag here. We can see we've got a drawstring here. This sits in the middle, and these strings go either side of the bag here and are anchored just around the corner here. And what's that design? That's designed to do, sorry, is to create a bit of a corner. If we tighten this up, this creates a pocket that allows us to tuck it over the top of a mat, which I'll show you a little bit more on shortly. We'll just keep running around the bag with all the features first. Coming around this side, same thing. We've got that same cord running around here. Halfway up the bag, you've got a little loop here. Now, these loops can be used to hang the comforter if you've got one hanging in your cupboard or something to allow the down to sort of store lofted. Otherwise, you can use this, and the straps don't come included, but you can use this to join this loop with a similar loop on the other side of the bag here to actually wrap around a mat. So you need to get a bit of shock cord or something yourself. They don't have straps that are made for this. Tie it off to this side here, loop it under your mat and over the other side, and it's going to wrap it around the mat because this is actually designed to sit over the top of a mat. So it doesn't have an underside, it sits over the top of the mat. Coming further around to the top of the bag here, we'll start with the drawstring. So there's two drawstrings on the top, and they're actually anchored in the middle. So because it's a double bag, it means each person has their own drawstring tension ability here. So you can tighten this side up to sit over the shoulders of the person on this side, and then there's another drawstring on this side here as well. So you can also tighten that up to sit over the shoulders of the person on that side. Now across the top, there's a few other things that I want to show you. Firstly, on the very corners, you've got more of these loops, and then you've got another one a little further in. Once again, you can use these to hang the bag, if you like, for storage. They also work to be compatible with Cedar Summit sleeping bags or potentially other sleeping bags if they match up. I'll show you a bit more on that shortly, but you can actually add this as another layer over the top of an existing double sleeping bag like this. And one last feature is these little studs in here. Can't tell you much information about this yet, but all I do know is that Cedar Summit makes sleep systems, so everything they make is usually designed to work with something else. This is more than likely going to be compatible with another product they've got coming out in the future that will probably allow you to clip something on the inside or underneath here or something. So watch this space, that will be compatible with something in probably the not too distant future. So I'll show you the few ways that you can use this bag. Now, firstly, you can use it just as a blanket. So wrap this around your shoulders, throw it over the top of your existing sleep setup if you like, however you want. You can just use it as a loose and lightweight blanket, but the built-in features allow you to actually attach it to a mat and also to other sleeping bags. And we'll start with the mat at this foot end here. So this is a Cedar Summit mat here. This mat measures about 128 centimeters in width and about 183 centimeters in length. So we can actually loop this over the end of the mat here by tightening this drawstring in the middle. So if we pull this, just so that those ends start to bunch up, creates this pocket in the corner here, and we just loop that over the corner of the mat like that. Do the same thing on the other side. And that then creates a bit like a fitted sheet, I suppose. We'll tighten that a little bit more. So that then fits over the top of that double mat. Now it will fit over a queen mat, which I've got underneath here. I'll show you that shortly, but I just want to show you that it fits on the double mat quite comfortably first. If we move up the bag here, up the comforter, we could just use this as it is there, but what I want to show you first is how you can use it over the top of two other Cedar Summit bags here. Now these are two compatible bags, zip side by side, so we've got a double sleeping bag here. I'm going to tuck these in underneath, and there's enough volume at the foot end here for that to stay lofted up. And if we come up to the top here, we can use these little loops to actually attach. You don't have to attach it if you don't want to, but you can use this loop to tuck this rope through and just tie this off on the toggle. There's a couple of toggles here. There's one around the neck and one around the hood there. If you just loop that over there, you can leave it sit like that if you like, but I find it's better to just give it a bit of a tie off like that. It's going to stay in place. Do the same thing on the other side here. And you've actually attached the comforter to the top of these sleeping bags. So you've extended the comfort range of these sleeping bags. Now you're not going to get an exact temperature rating for these two bags, for all of this joined together, but you've added another 700 grams to your down setup here, or to your sleep setup here. So that then gives you this nice, these sleeping bags are already nice and warm. You've got this whole layer on the top here. These loops on the side, I haven't tested all the combinations, but it's more than likely this will line up with perhaps some larger bags sitting side by side. Or if you did kind of want this to sit a bit looser, you could probably just loop this on here if you like, but then you kind of get that cold spot on the side there. So I'm gonna crawl in here, and I'll crawl on the men's side here just to show you how much foot space you've got down the other end. So this feels super cozy. I've got so much down on top of me here. It's about this thick sitting on top of me here. So heaps of down. If I lock down in the bag, I don't actually know what size this sleeping bag is here, but you can see this will go over my head here. And I have got heaps of space. There's heaps of down sitting over the top of my feet here still. So this being attached to the mat down the bottom here is still giving me plenty of volume up above in order for my feet to not get cold. So a nice warm setup in this respect. Second person lying next to me here, and that just sits loose over the top. Now you might be concerned about how strong these are, but there is a little bit of play in this, so it doesn't sit tight. So if you're moving around inside the bag rather than the bag rolling with you, this is a really, really warm setup here. So that's one way you can use the comforter. The other way is if you've just got, this would be a winter setup here. The other way is just use it for cool weather camping, or sort of not in the midst of summer, but take this off and remove the sleeping bags altogether. And you can actually just crawl in under the comforter by itself. So if I jump in here now, and just make sure we've got this looped over the end still, which it is, so that stays attached quite well, even though I moved it around a lot there. If I crawl in here, pull this over the top of me, you can see it's open on the side here now, but with the double mat, we've got sort of 15, 20 odd centimeters of overlap on each side here. So if there was a second person here lifting this up, you've got that overlap to sort of trap the warm air in there. And if I lie down, once again, give you an idea of how much foot space you've got. Looking, my feet feel like they've got tons and tons of room in there, heaps of room to move around. That's with my feet straight up and the down still lofted above my toes there. In this sort of setup, if you added a liner, which I've conveniently placed at a reach here, so I've got a double cotton liner here, use one of those inside here, crawl in the liner, this over the top, you've got a really good cool weather camp set up. Now the last, oh, I haven't showed you this feature here yet, which is not so relevant when you're using it with sleeping bags underneath, but when you're sleeping on this individual without the sleeping bags, tighten these up and it just creates a bit more of a pocket to wrap around your shoulder, particularly on this side, so you can wrap this over your shoulder just to hold it up around your head there. So the other person can do that on the other side, and then you don't have this cold spot here, it tucks under your body a little bit, so that's the benefit of that draw cord on the top. But to be honest, I think it would be quite warm just sitting over you like this. It's just like your doona you've got at home. Last thing I want to do is show you how it fits over a queen mat, because they do class this as a queen size comforter. It does fit over this, but you don't get quite as much space for your feet. Now you can also use the Tanami as somewhat of a single bag as well, if you like. So if you come to the foot section here and tighten this up so that you create sort of two pockets on each side here and fold it in half so that you're lying on one side and then crawl in. So as an individual, you've got the sleeping bag. So it's not ideal, I'm not saying this is ideal, but tighten that right up so you get a bit of a foot pocket there. Fold this in half like this, and you've now got somewhat of a single sleeping bag to lie in. So heaps of length in the bag. It comes right up above my head here. You do have this gap. You can't seal this up. I'm not hiding that fact, but it was just cool weather camping. You can lie down on this. Like, this feels quite good now. Sort of tuck this in and seal it off, and you've got yourself sort of a lightweight individual bag here as well. So last thing is to show you how to fit it on a queen mat. So it does fit. This is a queen comforter, but I find it fits best on, I've got this hooked over my foot here, I find it fits best on a double mat. So if I lay this out, you can see that it's gonna fit on this mat. Now this mat is 150 centimeters in width and 200 centimeters in length. So if I tighten this up a little bit again, loop it over the corner here, come to the other side and loop it over this corner as well. Got plenty of width in terms of securing it there. So I'll tighten this up a little bit more and that's now attached on the queen mat here. But we can see I haven't got quite the same volume at the foot end here. So I'll crawl inside and show you how it feels as a queen mat. So the length is pretty good. This mat's 10 centimeters in width. So this mat comes once again up to my shoulders here. But what I find is that the foot section here is just a little bit tighter. So I'm 183 centimeters. So my feet are right at the end. So I can feel it just firming over the top of my feet, but I still do have some down above my toes there. And I wouldn't necessarily sleep with them straight up anyway. So that's the only downside I find with having it on a queen mat, but it does work. Not quite the same overlap on each side here. You do get a little bit still, so a bit of room for each person to have this hanging over the side of the mat to trap the warmth. But you know, it does fit on a queen mat. And the reason I show you this is people will want to use a queen mat like this on top of a double stretcher, like what I've got it on here at the moment. A double size mat doesn't work as well on a stretcher like this because it kind of slopes like this with a bar in the middle, you end up rolling off the mat. So you kind of need a queen to come back up this side here. So this is still gonna work for a lightweight setup if you like to have a 150 wide mat on top of a double stretcher. So as with all Cedar Summit sleep products, they like to make sleep systems rather than just individual products, which means they're trying to get people to understand that how warm you sleep doesn't just depend on what you sleep under or what you sleep on. It's a combination of everything. So if you team this up with either the sleeping bags underneath or just by itself, depending on the temperature that you're on, put it on a nice warm mat like these guys here that's going to insulate from the ground up, and then team it up with some liners like the double cotton liner here. And there's also a heap of pillows in the Cedar Summit range as well. Use all that together and you get a good sleep system. And using this in your system, or a comforter like this in your camp system, adds a heap of flexibility to how it's all set up as well, so you're comfortable in a whole range of temperatures. That is the Tanami TM2 from Cedar Summit. You can check them out online at snowys.com.au, where you find them at our lowest prices every day. But if you do have any questions about them, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information. We'll check out some other cool Cedar Summit sleep products like these ones down here.